Hi guys, my name is Tibi. I'm the developer of the Ultimate 3D Carousel. I've just finished this remake basically. It's not an update, it's a remake. I've been working on this for almost, I don't know, 4 months I think. And I want to explain in this video tutorial how to work with the skin. So what I mean with the skin, let me choose a different example. So for example, let's go to controls and let's choose this one. So what I mean by skin are these icons, the scroll bar, the these buttons here, the video player icons and this stuff, also this icon. So the overall design of the lightbox, and I will show you how to do this first in the JavaScript version. And then I will show you in the WordPress version. They are basically the same. There are just a few differences between them. So first of all, in the download file, yes, because I'm not more than one, you will find this icon SVG file, icons fig file, dot fig file. So this is a Figma file. Figma is free, so all you have to do is to go to figma.com and create an account, and after everything is done, just drag the just drag the icons here somewhere inside Figma. The icons will be imported, and now if I open this, you will see this this two section file. So this one here, or just this one here, this side, it's for the video player. This one is for the lightbox. And this one at the bottom is for the carousel. So let me show you quickly what I mean by that. So again, let's go to the controls and open, I don't know, this one. So these are the lightbox skins. There's this stuff at the bottom, the controls, and also this icon here. And when I click on this, you will see that the video player, it's opening, and also the lightbox. So remember that I showed you that this is the light for the lightbox. These are the button lightbox, lightbox buttons. I'm sorry. See here, all this stuff, even the share ones. See. You can see them here, and then this for the video player, it's this stuff here, these buttons and all the controls here at the bottom. So this file contains all the necessary icons for it. These are the graphics icons, the PNG icons, and I forgot to tell you that the lightbox also supports vector skin. So when the vector skin is used, these icons will be ignored and the SVG files will be used for the entire carousel. I'm sorry. First, I will show you how to modify the graphic skin, and then I will show you how to use the vector font icon, depending on which one you want to use. Personally, they look the same, so it's up to you which one you want. There are advantages. For example, the graphics ones, they are very simple to modify. You can modify these buttons as you want, and they will look exactly the same in the carousel. And for the vectors, of course, these are vectors. They will look like a vector file, and it's a bit lighter to load, but this doesn't mean that this will load. It will take a long time to load because these files are very, very small. So either way, which one you use, you'll be fine. So let's move now to, let's close this for now. So again, first I will use the JavaScript version, not this one. I need to move them here because this is the wrong one. And let's see, I've closed it. One moment, please. So in the start folder, you will find these starter files from API up to the transparent images. These two ones are using the open source code, so please don't work with these two. So choose any of these files. I will choose the normal dark. Okay, I will just open it in the browser, and we have this example, and let's open it in the, let's close this stuff here. So this is how it looks in the code. No need to know this stuff, I just want to show you how it looks in the code. And let's say you want to change the color of the next button here in the carousel, okay? So let's go to Figma and let's choose the next button, which is this one. Please note that it has two states, so it has the normal state and the hover state. Let me show you here. So this is the normal state, and when I hover it, it has a selected state. All of them are the same, even the scroll bar and all this stuff here. Okay, so let's say we want to replace, let's make this, I don't know, I'll use some brutal colors here because I want to make a point. So the normal button is red, the normal state, and the hover state, I will make it green, something green. Okay. So now we have the buttons. Let's go into the content folder, because this is using the dark skin. Inside the content, you have to choose the skin dark. If you're using the white version, you have to use the skin white. This is the white version, by the way. So you see it, everything is different here on the white, on the light background, and this is different. So since we are working with the dark version, let's go here in the content and then in the skin dark. Okay, so this is just to show you a bit of the way it is structured. So this is skin dark and skin white are the skins for the carousel. What I mean by that, it's for all these buttons here at the bottom and these icons, okay? And then inside the RL file, you will find in the content folder, you will find the skin for the lightbox. So this is the skin for the lightbox, which I mean by that, I already showed you, but I'll show you again, these buttons. So if you want to modify the lightbox, you have to work in this folder. And then for the video player, you will find it here in the skin file. In the skin folder, I'm sorry. Okay, well, and for the video player, let me choose a different file here. Well, I think I already showed you, but anyway. So this is what I mean with the video player. This button and this, all this stuff here, it's found here in this folder. Okay, so I will show you how to modify it in the lightbox, and then everything else is the same. All you have to do is to repeat this process and you will be fine. So let's see the name of this file. So the name of this button, it's next button, see? And this one, it's a next button large selected, which is not good. I'll fix it now. Okay, so the name, it's next button over. All you have to do is to export them. So click on this one. Here on the right, scroll at the bottom and click on the plus icon here on export. Select the PNG format and export. And I'll just grab it, I'll drag it here on the desktop. And again, this is the hover state. So now I have these two buttons. I will just show here quickly. So I have them here made, okay. All you have to do is to cut them and then paste them in this folder and replace them. Now if I look for them, you'll see here the buttons. And now when I why is this so high, sorry about this, when I test the cover flow, I'm sorry, the carousel here, my brain's a mess today. You'll see that the buttons is red, and on hover it's the green one. So this is what you have to do to replace this stuff if you want to work with the graphic skins. This applies to the player and also the lightbox, as I already explained. I will not modify each button because it doesn't make any sense. It will take me 20 minutes, but you get the idea. If you want to change the color skin, you can do it here for the skin, okay? And now let me show you one thing I forgot to mention. If you refresh the page and you still see the old buttons, make sure that you clear the browser cache. See here this stuff, by holding on the keyboard Control Shift and Deal at the same time, and select only cached images and files. You don't want to clear your cookies and browser history, and clear, and you will see the file there. Okay, so this is how it's done with the graphic skin, and now let's move to the vector skin. In the Java, again, I will explain it first in the JavaScript and then I'll move to the WordPress. So don't worry if you are using WordPress, I didn't forget about it. So what you have to do in JavaScript to enable it, let me show you quickly that these are actually images here. If I click on this one, you'll see this is an image. This is the normal image and this is the selected image. And now if I set the use vector icons to yes, basically it looks the same as the old one, but you see this is not no longer the red and the green stuff. If I inspect this now, you will see that it's a vector file. You see here it's using a, if I click on the before stuff, it's using a font icon which is called FW3Dcar, which I will show you how to create in a moment, but I just wanted to show you this. So now, if you want to change the colors, because you might want to change this to different colors, just go into the, this is for JavaScript, go into the content and open the global CSS file. And here, you will see that this is structured, this CSS file is structured in a few sections, and let's go in the controls, see? In the 2.1, because you want to change the controls here. And white icon selected. Let me see, because there are a lot of them here, but I think this is the one selected. It's FFF. Okay, so this is, just in case you don't know which class it's applied to each element, just click on this small arrow once and then go to the element and click on it. And here on the right, I'm sorry, on the left side, you can see which class it's used. So in this case is this one, FW3DcarButton. Okay, I'll just copy it and then search for it here. And you see that it has this color, which is, I will make it red again so that we have the exact same thing as before. And now if I refresh it, you will see that the button, it's red. So this is the class for the buttons. And on hover, it's white. And you will see also here the selected, you see, FW3DcarButton and the selected one. And I will make this green. This is a simple hexadecimal color. It's not difficult to find the color that you need. And now when I hover, you see that it's green. So this applies to everything. You will find in this class, in this CSS file, we'll just undo what I've done here. You will find for the classes for everything. So here in the second part is the controls. In the first one is the caption. What I mean by caption, it's this stuff that appears under the carousel, this text. For example, let's make the title red for this one, Peekaboo, where are you? So again, if you don't know what which class is, you just hover it and you will see that is a FW3Dcar title. Select it, copy it, and then search for it here and you will see that it's here. And let's make the color red. And now if I refresh it, actually I think I didn't create this right. Let me see. Okay, now it's red. See, now it's the caption, it's red. And of course you can change everything that you want. For example, the font size right now it's 18 pixels. Let's make it 40 pixels. I think it will look weird, but just in case to see how it works. Other stuff has to be fixed here in the CSS, but you see how it's I just showed you quickly how the captioning works. So everything here it's structured in pieces. This is for the menu, this is for the carousel and lightbox video player. This section is for the lightbox, and then here is the vector font which I will show you after in a moment how to use it, how to create it, how to use it. Okay, so I will not stay here and show you which button how to change, because it doesn't make any sense. I've showed you how to change the vector skin and also here the graphic skins. All you have to do is to repeat this process for each button and each class. It's very, very simple. So let me show you now the vector font. So to create this vector font that has this, all these icons, which are these ones, these vector files, I already saved the SVG files here in the download files. You will find the SVG which contains all these icons here. So these icons from here are these icons from the vectors, the vector font. I just grab them by selecting an icon and select the formats to SVG and then export. And then I've copied all of them in the folder. So this is how I've done this. What you have to do is to get all these SVG files that you see here and save them as a eco as a vector font. I've used this website to create this stuff, and I've clicked on the Ecomon app, and here also the icons are already added. I'll just delete them to show you how this works. So all I have to do is to go into this app here and create a new project, I think, I'm not sure. And when you see this screen, just select all the icons and grab them and drag them here. I'm sorry, not this one. In the untitled one, I think. Let me try again. You have to drag them in the untitled set. See? Then you have to select them all by click and drag on all of them and generate font. After you generate the font, you'll see this screen. You see all those icons here, and each icon has this code, which is the actual CSS file, CSS style used to create these icons. Just go on preferences and make sure that you set the font name to this stuff and the font and the class prefix to this stuff. This is all you have to do. After this, you have to download the font and grab these fonts. This is all that you have to do. Grab this fonts folder from here and paste it in the content folder. I'm sorry, let me see, I'm not sure. In the content folder here, just replace this fonts folder. You see, it does the exact same thing. And if you want to change the icons to something else, just modify here the SVG files. Just make sure that they all have the same width and height, okay? It's very important. Not make this, I don't know, something like this, because it will not work anymore correctly. So this is how it's done to create the vector font. Again, it's your choice which one you use. I like both. They are both there, and you can choose the one that you think is best for you. Okay, and now in the WordPress version, for the font stuff, you have to do the same thing, only that you have to add the fonts folder inside the CSS file here. This is the structure of the WordPress plugin version. And that's all you have to do it in the folders here. And for the graphic skins, you have the same stuff as the JavaScript version. There is the content folder here, and the structure is the same. I'll not explain it again, so please watch it again. And inside the WordPress, let me show you a few things. So this is how the settings for the carousel it's looking. First of all, the CSS editor, you will see here the exact same thing that I have explained you in the JavaScript version, only that here you have to make some changes and you have to make the changes and then click on the update CSS file to make an update. And for the general settings, to set the vector skin, all you have to do it in your preset that you create. Again, this is a bit confusing if you didn't saw the video tutorial for the WordPress version, but the idea is, in this tutorial, I just want to show you how to change the skin. That's it. So do not worry about other stuff here, because I will explain it in another video tutorial. So to use the vector skin, all you have to do is go here to the use vector skin icons and set it to yes and update it. And then this preset will be used. Now it will use the vector skin instead of the graphic skin. If you want to go back, just set it to no and update. So this is everything about this subject. At first sight it might seem a bit complicated, but it's not. I'm sure that once you'll start working with this, it will make sense. Okay guys, thank you for watching and have a very good day. Bye bye.